And here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Commerce Bank after the lender updated its capital returns policy and plans to return 3 billion euros to shareholders as dividends and share buybacks. Shares of the German bank are up over 11% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of Apple, whose staff reportedly met with Chinese officials in recent months to discuss Beijing's crackdown on Western apps. Apple shares are up 0.7% before the bell. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of Eli Lilly after it settled a whistleblower lawsuit over manufacturing problems. Shares of the American pharmaceutical firm are flat in pre-market trade.
Markets capped off the week and the quarter on a mixed note. For Friday, the Hong Kong Hang Seng led gains after being battered for days on worries over China's property sector. As for Japan's Nikkei 225, it closed in negative territory as investors digested key economic data. That includes industrial and retail activity coming in better than expected, while consumer confidence fell to its lowest in 6 months. For the month and quarter, most markets in the region posted steep losses amid worries over higher for longer interest rates, high oil prices, and China's tumbling economy. Here at home, Philippine shares snapped a six-day winning streak with the main index slumping 1%. COL Financial's Juanis Barredo sees more consolidation ahead.
Market to be able to do some rotation. That means some issues that rallied first might get some pullbacks, and then for those that are a bit laggards, maybe give them an opportunity to rally, and that might keep the index pinned into a consolidation. As a year end, I'll have to stretch those targets out a little bit. We still do have the ability to come back down, so I'm thinking maybe a low point of about 6.2 with a high side of about the 6.750.
For the week and the month, the PSEI is up, but for the quarter, it's down more than 2% and down 3.7% year-to-date. Philstock Financial's Japet Antiangco sees slower earnings in the upcoming reporting season, and that could be a drag on the local market again.
Full year of 2023, our projection for corporate earnings is it's going to, you know, to lie within 5 to 15%. So taking that into consideration for this third quarter, we could see a slower corporate earnings growth, and this is attributed to the challenges that you have mentioned. Inflation is going to hit consumer spending, and consequently it's going to hit the revenue of our companies, and at the same time you have these rising costs of production.
Back to China's property woes, the sector is showing signs of further deterioration in September. That's according to independent survey China Beige Book, which said prices contracted this month as sales slowed. Corporate borrowings also fell as lenders grew cautious of risk exposure following the debt issues hounding the real estate sector. At the heart of those troubles is China Evergrande, the world's most indebted developer with more than $300 billion in total liabilities. But at least one analyst says Evergrande's downfall is unlikely to result in a global financial crisis.
The current issue, as I mentioned, is primarily related with the trust products in China and their associated investors. And these are the mostly domestic institutional investors, not the global investors. They owned enterprises hold a significant positions in terms of the market capitalization and sales in the real estate market in China. So if necessary, these state-owned enterprises can acquire the struggling real estate developers. For example, Evergrande, they can acquire these private real estate developers and facilitate the restructuring, and they can reduce the likelihood of widespread crisis.